Today, I'm looking at one of the questions that pops up quite often here. It's how to do automation in Waveform. I'm Zane from AudioTechTV.com, and for this Waveform 11 tutorial, I'm using Waveform Pro, but what I'm showing you will also work with Waveform Free. Now, let's jump in. Some of the basic things that you can automate are the volume and the pan, so that's what I'm going to look at right now, and then I'll look at automating plugins after. So beside each track right here, you're going to notice the A. And if you click on that and you go to automate parameters for this track, you'll see everything that you can automate on this track right now. So what I suggest doing is clicking on this plus button here, then click on add an empty automation track. And we have a new automation track, and you can keep adding these over and over if you have multiple things that you want to automate on the one track. But for this, I'm just going to automate the volume. And to do that, we can just click on the A and drag it right here to the volume. It's going to ask if we want to do volume or pan. Click on volume. And now we have this line here. And you'll notice if I click and drag the line, it moves the fader up and down. Another way that you could assign this is by clicking on the A on the automated track, and then you could go to the automatable parameters for this track and click on volume, whichever works best for you. So now we can automate this, and there's a couple of ways you can do this. You can easily just use your mouse to draw in some automation points, so we'll do that. You can double click anywhere on this line here and create a node. And then double click over here to create another one. And we can pull this one down, and that's an automation. So watch as we do a playback. All right, so that's a simple automation right there. We're just turning the volume down. If you want to get rid of all your nodes, you can just click on the line anywhere. Then you can go down here to delete points from curve and delete all the points. And we're back to none. So another way that we can do the automation is by recording it. And we can just click this button here. That's the record automation button. Press play for playback and then control it. And now you'll notice we have the automation that we just created by moving the fader up and down. And one thing you'll want to make sure is that you have this green button enabled. And I think it's enabled by default, so you won't even have to worry about it unless you disabled it. And this just plays the automation back. If you have it disabled, it's going to ignore all the automation information that you have in there. So just make sure that's enabled. So now another way that we can do this is by using a MIDI keyboard. Now, if you have a MIDI controller or a MIDI keyboard like this one, and it has a bunch of knobs on it, some other controls on it other than the keys, you might want to set it up so it can control various things in plugins and within Waveform itself. Now, let's look at how to do that. To set up your MIDI controller for automation, click on the MIDI Learn button down here, and then click on the parameter that you want to control with your MIDI keyboard. So I want to control the volume. And now turn the knob on your MIDI controller or MIDI keyboard that you want to use. And it's just set that assignment. So now let me close this, turn off MIDI Learn. And you'll notice when I turn the knob on my MIDI keyboard, it controls that fader. And now we can record that. So let's record that. And of course, you can assign it to whatever controls you want. Most functions are automatable, and a lot of plugins allow you to automate various features in there. So let's load a plugin now just to look at that. All right, so I have an EQ plugin loaded up, and I'm just going to add another empty automation track, drag the A onto the plugin that you want to automate, and now it's going to show you all of the features that you can automate in this plugin. And for this, I'm just going to go to band 3 gain. So I'm going to click on band 3 here so it's active. And you'll notice now when I move the line down here, it's controlling the gain of band 3. So let's record the automation of that. I have the automation record button enabled. Now I'll just hit play. And you can see our automation down here. Now this can be great for virtual instruments that might have knobs that you want to adjust during a song, or on effects like filters and EQs, but of course the possibilities are endless. If you want to check out even more Traction Waveform tutorials, click up here, or click down here to see what YouTube thinks you should watch next. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more videos from me. Thank you so much for watching. For Simple Green Tech, I'm Zane. Keep creating, and we'll talk soon.